What's up guys, T-Mart here, and I bring you guys my 500,000 subscribers special video today. So first of all, thanks to all of you guys. I really appreciate all the support you've given me over the past couple of years that I've been on YouTube. And you know, I could never thank you guys enough. So thank you. But anyway, so today we're gonna be taking a look at my gaming setup in my house. So this is the house I've lived in for like the past 12 years or so, and I'm actually getting ready to move, as a lot of you guys know, out to California. So I wanted to get this up to let you guys know what I was working with for the past 12 years or the past 2.5 years that I've been on YouTube, and then I'll get you guys an updated version after I've moved, and we can see what changed. So anyway guys, thanks again for all your support, and let's get started.
Alright, so as we come inside here, we're gonna go downstairs because that's where all the magic happens. Upstairs is just the kitchen, that's where the women make me food while I game, so that's less important. But anyway, so down here, this is just kind of like the living room area. As you can see, we have a Vizio flat screen. It's all right, it's not the biggest in the world, but it works well. And below it is the Wii, baby. Yes, thing is awesome. I play it all the time. Just kidding, not really. I actually bought it from my mom for Christmas one year because you know, there are all those news articles and stories about how great the Wii was because it could, you know, help you burn calories and work out while you had fun. So I bought it and bought her a couple of games. Family Feud is all right. Just Dance 2 is really funny to watch people do it because they just look really, really dumb when they dance. And then also The Biggest Loser, that's the real game that she wanted, and it sucks. You know, the workouts are really awkward looking, and you know, you feel awkward, and it doesn't work. It's dumb. It's kind of a waste. So the Wii, I don't know, maybe I'll have to bust it out for a gameplay sometime. Think about like an interactive Black Ops 2 on the Wii or something like that. We may have to work that out, but some anyway, back here, this is just like the mini bar, mini fridge area. So I've got some Dr. Pepper up there, some Dr. Pepper inside, some Mountain Dew and some waters, and a bunch of Dew over here that was left over from last year. You guys know that if you bought these bottle caps, you got 15 minutes of XP on Modern Warfare 3. So I bought a ton of Dew so I could get that, and then I also gave away a lot to you guys as well. So anyway, let's get into my actual setup because that's what you guys want to see. So here we go. Alright guys, so here we are. This is my setup. This is why I spend a lot of my time making videos for you guys, playing video games, etc., etc. So let's take a quick tour, shall we? So first of all, over here, this is my games collection. It's not the biggest in the world. I usually sell a lot of my games on eBay once I'm done with them, so this is just what I have left. And down below in this stack, this is definitely my most played pile here. So of course, Battlefield 3 and Halo Reach are fun from time to time. And then of course, I have all the Call of Duty games, Black Ops and Modern Warfare 2 are up top. Black Ops doesn't have a case because as you guys may remember from my, my Wiz Khalifa parody music video, I used it as my gold chain, which if you guys haven't seen that video, you should definitely go check it out. I'll link it on screen. But anyway, so back over here, these two games right here, Max Payne 3 and Ghost Recon Future Soldier, they're both a lot of fun. I'm actually doing Let's Plays on my second channel right now with those games. So if you guys want to check those out, definitely do it. I'm having a lot of fun with those videos. This right here is my cell phone. It's an iPhone 4S, but unfortunately, as you can see, if we can get this in focus here, it's been beat up a little bit. It's got some cracks. I've dropped it a couple of times, and kind of sucks. But the coolest thing is the case. So check that out right there. Yes, it's an old Game Boy, like original case. And I don't know, I love it. Definitely the most fun part of my gaming career was playing Pokemon games like Red and Blue and Crystal, Gold, and Silver on the Game Boy. So I had to pay tribute to that, and I don't know, I think it's pretty awesome. Now, moving on right here. This is my Gamma Lab stash. As I'm sure you guys know, a bunch of us commentators are sponsored by these guys, and it's just, it's great. It's a great product. It's a cheaper and healthier energy drink that that tastes great and works great, so there's really nothing else you could ask for. If you guys want to try it out, I can get you 15% off. Just check the description. But anyway, moving up here, this is my Modern Warfare 2 GameStop 1v1 tournament championship certificate, I guess you could say. I beat like 128 people in my town and won that, so I don't know, I thought it was pretty cool. It was on the opening release night of the game. And then over here to the right, this is my Control Freak stash. As you guys know, I love Control Freaks. I've been playing with them for like 3 years, and I've been collecting them. So I collect them like baseball cards. I use them like they're freaking crack or something like that, and I would highly recommend them to anybody who ever wants to try them. Check the link in the description, but no, I would not recommend crack. That was kind of a bad comparison there. But anyway, so moving on up here, this is my subscribe pillow that my mommy made for me. So she's awesome. She supports me in everything that I do, and I really appreciate it. So I thought it was really cool of her to do that. And then also over to the right, this is just some of my Call of Duty Elite stuff. I've got some shot glasses. I've got an iPhone case. I got a belt buckle somewhere, and there's a couple other things that are really cool. So that stuff's awesome. And then my Twitch TV flask. And if you guys have ever played Heavy Rain, you were supposed to make an origami crane during the opening loading screen of the game, and I made one, but it's missing its head. So I'm not a pro folder, but I don't know, I kept it anyway. I've got a headless crane in here. I thought it was pretty cool. But anyway, so let's move on to the technology part of this. This is what you guys came here to see. So first of all, this is my Xbox. You might notice that it's the original one. It hasn't red ringed yet, and you might be wondering how, especially because I play it so much, how have I kept it cool to where it won't red ring? Well, the trick is these things under here. So you can see those are contact lid cases. You could also use like the top of a soda bottle, and it's just they lift it up off the ground so you can get air underneath it, and it helps keep it cool. So I would really suggest you guys do this to your console, whether you have Xbox or PS3. It's gonna keep it cooler, it's gonna make it last longer, and it's just it's gonna be good for it. So do that if you want to take care of your stuff. But anyway, this right here is my Astro Mix Amp. That's how you control the volume and the game versus voice sound. You can turn it on just by pressing this button, and bam, there you go. Dolby Digital surround sound. It goes up to my Astros right here, which are awesome. Check it out, red with the red and blue T-Martin logo. I love that. It looks awesome. I couldn't thank them enough for the amazing audio equipment that they make. This is my PS3 here. I've got the old fat PS3. I don't have the Slim yet. I don't need it. It works great. It's a freaking tank. It doesn't break like the Xbox does. And a lot of guys ask if I ever play PS3. I do from time to time, but for the most part I play Xbox just because that's where all my friends are. So you know, that's that. I mean, a lot of people always ask me that. So this is my webcam. It's a Logitech C510. It's nothing special. It's just an HD webcam. It works well. It was really cheap. And this is my TV. So a lot of people have these really pimp computer monitors with like 2 milliseconds lag and stuff, and I've still been using this old kind of crappy 19-inch Element Walmart, I guess you could call it flat screen TV, and it works for me. It's starting to go out though, so I think I'm gonna buy a new monitor, and you guys will see that in the updated setup video after I've moved. So we'll see that soon. This here is my easy button, definitely the coolest part of my setup, because let's say you're in a Call of Duty match and the other team is talking crap and then you beat them. There's nothing better than doing this.
That was easy.
It's so rewarding, and everybody in the lobby cracks up. So if you guys don't have an easy button, you definitely have to get one. It's a lot of fun. Now over here, this thing's really cool. If you guys have two consoles that you want on the same TV, rather than when you want to switch to PS3 and having to change the component cables in the back of the TV and stuff, this thing puts them all into one. So there's three inputs and then one output, and so right now it's on Xbox. I press a button, boom, over to PS3. Boom, back to Xbox. So it's really cool, it's really convenient, and if you guys, like I said, if you have two or three consoles, it's definitely worth it. It saves you a lot of time. And then underneath that, that is my Hopog HD PVR. That's how I record gameplay, and it works pretty well. It's kind of old. I think it might be starting to go out, but we'll have to wait and see. I might have to upgrade to a Blackmagic Intensity Pro. But anyway, moving on. This is my computer here. It's a custom-built PC. I'm not exactly sure on the specs. It's an i7 Sandy Bridge, 16 gigs of RAM, you know, a pretty nice video card. I don't know. It's a decent PC, but I might be upgrading here soon because I need something new. I need something better. And to check out those LEDs, that's pretty sick. I know LEDs are lame, man, but I don't know. I kind of like it. But anyway, so over here, this is my computer. The monitor is just like a 23-inch Acer H233H, I think. It works well. It looks good. The colors are nice, and I don't know, there's nothing too special about it. I have to get two monitors here soon. Everybody has them and everybody loves them except for me. This is my keyboard, Logitech G510. It works really well. It's got some cool programmable keys over here, so you can tell them to do whatever you want, and you can just press them once and it'll do that, so you can make sentences, you can do whatever you want to do. It's pretty sweet. My mouse is a Razer Death Adder. I don't really do too much PC gaming, but I'm starting to get more and more into it, and this mouse is pretty good. It's super smooth, and it works really well for me. Over here, this is my microphone. It's Audio Technica AT2020, I think. And you know, most people have like blue snowballs or blue Yetis, and I just thought they looked boring, and I wanted something really, really cool. So check that out. It's like a freaking alien thing with like the support here, and it glows blue, and I thought it looked really cool. It looked kind of professional, so that's why I got it. I think it's pretty awesome, and the pop filter is kind of cool. So that's the mic I have. I really like it. It sounds really good. And if you're getting into commentating, I mean, it's a good one. I think it's only like $100 or something, which is kind of expensive, but it's definitely worth it because it sounds great. Now, moving over here, this is kind of like the last part of my setup. These are my Astro bags. They're really, really great. I mean, everything Astro makes, from its headsets to its bags, are all super, super top quality. This one is like a backpack. And the one under it is more of like a duffel bag. So they both work great. If you guys want to check those out, again, the link is going to be in the description. This over here is my 15-inch MacBook Pro. I think it's got an i7 processor in there, and it works well. I don't really know how to edit on Mac, so I'm actually boot camping it right now, putting Windows on it, so that'll be cool. This is a 3 terabyte Seagate hard drive, and it works really well. It's compatible with both PC and Mac, so it's pretty convenient. This over here is my Astro A30s. So a lot of people always want to see those and see the comparison or the differences between A30s and A40s. These are the A30s, these are the A40s. As you can see, the A30s are just smaller. They sit on top of your ear, whereas the A40s sit over your ear. So for gaming, the A40s are more comfortable, no doubt about it. The A30s are great for like listening to music, or if you're trying to take them on, you know, trips or anything and you want to talk on Skype or have a mic for your computer. But you know, if you're just looking for a strictly gaming headset, I think the A40s are the way to go. Now, coming back over here, some of the last stuff, this is just some of the recording equipment I use. I'm currently recording this video with a Canon Rebel T2i. I've got a couple of GoPros, and this is a Sony Bloggy. It's a little handheld camera that you can carry around in your pocket, and so is the Flip, which I love the Flip, but it was recently discontinued, so that kind of sucks. So those are those, and oh, hold up. Boom! Check me out! I have a Roxio game capture. Machinima sent it to me to review a long time ago, way before those annoying commercials came on, and I actually did a review about it. So if you guys haven't seen that video, you can go check it out. The Roxio is a decent capture card. It's not as good as the HD PVR, but it is decent. So if you guys want to check that out, you can. But I don't know, I thought it was funny because those commercials are so freaking annoying, man. But anyway, that's about it. Got an old PC right there, and a balance board, an old shirt that I used when I used to play competitively at LANs in the area. I wanted my freaking gamer tag on the back. That's kind of nerdy. Oh yeah, the green screen. There's nothing really too much to say about that. I got it. I thought I was going to use it a lot. I haven't really yet. I used it once or twice in my Gunner Optics video, you know, the music parody. But other than that, I haven't really put it to use yet, so maybe I'll have to use it in the future and make a, I don't know, maybe a sex tape or something. But anyway, all right, hold up. There's one more thing I want to show you guys. So even me, who has an extreme fanboyish love for Call of Duty, I did that. Modern Warfare 3 brought it out in me one night. I don't remember what it was. I got really mad, and it's not like I like straight on knuckle punched the door, knuckles first. I kind of like slapped it because I didn't want to punch a hole in the door. I just wanted to freaking let out my anger and bang on something, and somehow I guess my palm went through it or something, and I have a pretty bad little tape job there, and I don't even think I've told my mom about this yet. So mom, if you're watching this video, I'm sorry. I guess I'll help you fix that, or buy a new door maybe, or you know, I don't know if you can fix that. So I thought it was kind of funny. I went freaking Wings of Redemption on my door, and at least I didn't bayonet my TV or anything. No, just kidding. I love Wings. But anyway, let's take it outside. Alright guys, so there you have it. That was my 500,000 subscriber special video. You guys saw my setup, and of course I will bring you the updated version as soon as I move. So thank you guys so much for watching. Thanks for all your support over the past 2.5 years. But before you guys go, I want to introduce you to one more special person in my life. Sadie, come here. Hey, come here, baby. Oh, baby. This is my baby girl. My little baby girl, Sadie. Aw, thank you for the kisses. She's 14, I think, so she's getting up there, but she'll always be my baby, and she's a Black Lab Border Collie mix. So thank you guys so much again for watching, and I'll catch you guys later. Lots of great videos coming soon. Peace out.